Okay, Laura, let's defend the title right now as we load in two brand new decks of cards and meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Yvonne Solworth. Hello, Yvonne. Good to have you. Good firm handshake. Tell us about yourself, Yvonne.
Okay, I'm Yvonne, and I'm from Pensacola, Florida, and I'm out here in California working for the summer to buy my engagement ring because my boyfriend can't afford it, so, you know, the least he can do is marry me after I buy it, and if I get anything on the show.
Oh, good. That's... Has he proposed, or after you get the ring, are you going to say then you have proposed?
Right. The ring, and then to the church. That's it.
Okay. That's it. Good to have you here, Yvonne. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Laura, the upper cards, the red cards. And Laura, we asked 100 married men, have you ever eaten something that your wife cooked, which if you were in a restaurant, you would have sent back? How many men said they had?
Oh, boy. I can imagine a lot of people would have sent something back. I'm going to say 50.
50 yeah. Have eaten something at home that the wife cooked that they would have sent it back in a restaurant, Yvonne.
Hey, you haven't lived until you've eaten my mother's cooking. She can't boil water. I'm sorry. I say it's higher.
Has your father done that through the years? Eaten everything mom puts in front, huh?
For 9 kids worth.
This just keeps on eating, right?
Really?
The actual number of married men who've eaten something that their wife cooked, which they would have sent back if they'd been at a restaurant, is 50. Right on the button.
Oh,
Laura.
Hey.
Wow.
That's funny.
Ooh. And Laura, you start with a 4.
I'm going to keep the 4 and go higher.
Higher than a 4? No, it's a 2. It's not higher. Yvonne, a break for you to play a 3.
Hey!
I say it's higher.
Higher than a 3? Yes, a 4.
All right. And I'm not going to stop. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to say the next card is higher still.
Higher than a 4? Yes,
you're
right.
Freeze.
You're freeze. And we move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away. Yvonne, can you talk if your hands aren't moving? I'm just curious. The question goes to you, Yvonne. We asked 100 women who support the women's liberation movement. Have you ever proposed marriage to a man? We didn't know this was coming up. How many feminists had proposed to a man, with or without the ring, Yvonne?
That's not a fair question. Well, I haven't proposed, but no. I think it's about 20.
20 feminists have proposed to a man, Laura.
I've proposed to a man. I'm going to say higher.
Did he say yes?
Higher.
Did the man say yes?
Oh, did he say yes? No.
No. Oh, doggone. Yours didn't either. Well, these sisters are going to have a little talk here. The actual number of feminists who said they proposed to a man is 26. It's higher, Laura.
Great. Fantastic.
Do you want the 4, Laura?
I'm going to keep that 4. It's been unlucky for me, but I'm going to go higher with it.
This time, is it going to be higher?
Yes,
it is. A 9.
Good. Freeze on the 9.
Freezing it. Laura needs 3 cards. Yvonne needs 2. And the question to you, Laura. We located 100 geniuses. These are all people whose IQ is above the genius level. And we asked the geniuses, do you think the United States would be better off if only geniuses were allowed to be president? How many geniuses said yes?
Oh, if they're geniuses, I'm sure their ego's right up there. So I'm going to say about 65.
65 geniuses said only a genius should be allowed to be president, Yvonne.
Well, you look at it and you say the guys that have been president are supposed to be geniuses anyway, right? So, and they haven't done so well, so I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower. I agree with you about them not doing so well, but I question whether some of them have been geniuses. Yvonne says lower. The actual number of geniuses who said the United States would be better off if only geniuses were allowed to be president is 15. Very much lower, Yvonne. You know what it is? I figured it out. They're too smart to want the job. That's what it is. You got an 8, Yvonne.
I want to change it.
Changing
the 8? I want to change it.
To a queen.
All right. Hey, Yvonne. I'm going to say that the next card is lower.
Lower than a queen. Yes!
And I'm going to keep going, and I'm going to say the next card is higher.
For the first game in the match, if this is higher than a 2, it is! Yvonne wins it. Game 1. Let's set it for game 2, Janice. First game. game to the challenger with one game and $100. Same two decks of cards. Janice will put them in, and we'll start game two with a question to you, Yvonne. We asked 116-year-old boys, if you had to give up one thing, which would it be, sports or girls? How many 16-year-old boys said they would give up sports?
All of them, probably. I'll say about half and half, about 51. 51 would give up sports.
51 would give up sports, Laura.
Well, I think 16-year-olds are a little more sophisticated today than they were before. I'm going to say higher.
Higher.
Yeah.
The actual number of 16-year-old boys who would give up sports but not girls is 89. It's higher, Laura.
Fantastic. Good.
Laura, you're starting with a queen.
I'm going to keep the queen and say lower.
Lower than a queen. Yes, a jack.
Oh, good. I'm going to keep going and say lower.
Lower than a jack. Oh, no, an ace. It's not lower. And Yvonne, the challenger, gets a chance to play an eight. Can't change it.
I know. Okay, I think that the next card is going to be lower.
Lower than an eight. No, it's a jack. It's not lower. You know what's coming now, Yvonne?
What?
A commercial. We'll be right back right after this. Now, you are trying to buy a ring so you can get a guy.
Right.
You proposed and the fella said no, huh?
Yeah.
Two lovely ladies like yourselves. Doggone it. We got to do something about that. If any of you would like to help out these young ladies, please send in a card. We pulled no. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive Arabia Finland's Ruska stoneware. Safe for dishwasher, refrigerator, and oven, even microwave ovens. A Scandinavian design that's practical as well as beautiful, furnished by Arabia Finland. And some of our contestants will receive a Blue Luster shampoo, a new Blue Luster Plus carpet shampoo with grease cutters and brighteners to remove ground-in dirt and grime. And Amarok's new decorating accents for the bath in a popular traditional style. Amarok, a leader in fine decorative hardware. And Serta's Perfect Sleeper mattress and exclusive Serta Lock Foundation provides firm support where you need it, luxurious comfort where you want it, Perfect Sleeper by Serta. And Eureka's new ESP Extra Suction Power Vacuum. 50% more power, more beating, brushing, and cleaning action. Six-way height adjustment furnished by Eureka. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.